Hello and welcome to another quick edit video with the sunset image of the Lake of Constance in southern Germany. My goal here is to restore a lot of detail from those underexposed areas, while I'm not overexposing too much, and I also want to apply a very dreamy look with strong sunset colors on this shot. So let's go. Okay, again I'm in the Camera Raw editor, and before I start changing anything I want to head down to the geometry tab. And that's because maybe you can see it, but those vertical lines aren't really straight, and I want to fix that by simply playing around with the vertical slider in the geometry tab. In this case I need to add a little bit here, but that looks pretty good. Also, I already have cropped the image, just so you know, but let's continue with the editing. First off, let's change the profile to Adobe Standard. This will slightly make the darker areas brighter, so that's helpful. And right away I want to adjust the white balance. So let's just make it a little warmer so we get this nice sunset feeling. And that should be enough. At this point, the biggest problem is the underexposure. So let's try to fix it by bringing up the exposure. Just a tiny bit. I will fix most of those things using local adjustments. We could also try to adjust the shadows, so let's erase them a little bit, and even the blacks. You can see that really wasn't that helpful. I could of course increase the exposure way more, but that would just end up in overexposure. So instead, let me do one local adjustment real quick, and for this I'm using a gradiated filter. And I'm just focusing on this one outside of this image, because this one will cover everything. So to fix the exposure, I first want to prevent the highlights from being affected. And for this reason, I'm using a luminance range mask. So we can visualize the luminance map. Right now everything is affected here. If I filter out the highlights, of course the brighter areas won't get changed. So that's exactly what we want. Let's bring it down a little bit. And now we can also make it a little softer on the edges. But that should look pretty good. And now I can simply bring up the exposure without risking too much overexposure. So let's go up quite a bit. And at the same time, I still want to bring down the highlights. Just look at the histogram, it's a very nicely exposed image now. So back to the basic adjustments. Of course, due to this change, we did lose some contrast. So let's fix that. Alright. And then I also want to add a little bit of vibrance for some more saturation. Okay, now we're done with the basic adjustments. The overall image still lacks a little bit of contrast, but we can already start to see a dreamy kind of effect on this picture. So let's continue with some local adjustments. You can see there are quite a few gradiated filters, and here I want to go clockwise, starting with the upper one for the sky. And to add contrast, I'm simply dropping the exposure towards the edges of the image. So I'm starting here with the sky, and let's just slightly bring down the exposure here. Alright, then let's head to the next one for the right side. And again, I'm bringing down the exposure. So the right side isn't that important here. I want the main focus to be on the center, so that works quite good. Now for the foreground, however, I actually want to increase the whites, making it a little brighter. And I also want to add clarity, which works really nice here, and maybe some texture. Okay, now we do have another one for the foreground, and that's just to add a little bit of contrast here. Okay, nice. And finally, we have this gradiated filter on the left side. And again, I'm just bringing down the exposure. Nice, this looks already much, much better. Then let's work on the radial filters. As usual, I'm using them to add glow to the bright spot in the sky. So here you can see I have two differently sized radial filters above that spot. And I'm starting with the smaller one. Now I'm just pumping up the blacks. And I'm also decreasing the dehaze. Again, this might overexpose this area, so I'm also dropping the highlights a bit. Alright, and then we can add a little bit of color by increasing the temperature. And we could even increase the tint here. I think this will look good. Alright, now let's switch to the bigger radial filter here. Again, I'm increasing the blacks. Not as much as with the first one, however. Also, I'm not touching the dehaze, but I want to introduce some more temperature here, as well as some tint. Alright, nice. Then we have one radial filter left for the foreground. And here I just want to make the water a little brighter so it fits the sky. This looks good. Then let's also add some clarity. And maybe a little bit of temperature. Just like that. Nice, and that's it for the local adjustments. Then let's head to the color grading. And in fact, I'm heading straight to the split toning in the color grading tab. And here we can really make those sunset colors come out. So for the highlights, let's go with the warm color tone. I want to go more into the yellow range. And let's bring up the saturation a bit. Okay. And for the midtones, I am doing the same thing, applying a warm color tone. Maybe let's even go into the orange color tones and slightly bring up the saturation here. Okay, then finally for the shadows, I'm going to apply a cold color tone. Of course, the saturation is way over the top right now, so I'm bringing it down. But that looks much, much better. Alright, and now let's go into the effects and add a little bit of vignetting. Just like that. And finally, in the details tab, I'm going to sharpen this image. And now let's open it up in Photoshop to finish the editing. So first off, we need to fix a few things. Let's just duplicate that layer by hitting Ctrl J. So we just have a backup layer. And now, first off, I want to fix the vignetting, so I'm picking the clone stem tool. Let's check this corner right here. I'm just cloning out this part. And then comes the tricky stuff. So I'm grabbing the lasso tool by pressing L, and let's get rid of this lamp. I'm just making a very, very rough selection here. Just like that. Then I'm hitting Shift F5 with the content aware selected. I'm hitting OK. That was pretty good. Now I also want to remove this strange looking square rock. Again, just making a rough selection here. Shift F5 and hit OK. Alright, nice. Then we have a lot of people on this boardwalk. I think those people in the distance don't really matter, but those two dudes right there are super distracting. And I'm scared of trying to remove them because this will be very hard. So let's see what the lasso tool and the content aware fill can do here. Again, just making a rough selection. And let's pray it works. It wasn't that bad. Alright then, let's try the same thing on the other guy. Alright, this looks kind of weird, but we can fix that again using the clone stem tool. Okay, I think that's good enough. So next up, let's add some more glow in the center of this image. So I'm adding a new layer, and let's switch the blending mode to hard light. Then I'm grabbing the brush, pick up a color from up there by holding down the Alt key and clicking in here. And then let's bring down the brush opacity to not make this effect too strong. Just like that. And now I'm just painting in once or twice to make this glow effect a bit stronger. Okay, that looks really cool. I think that's also enough already. So let's merge everything here. Now I also want to apply a little bit of dodging. So let's add a new layer, and I'm using the TK panel plugin as usual. And in this case, I want to dodge the rock in the foreground. So this should be a very good mask here. Let's apply this to our new layer. Also, we need to change blending mode of this layer to overlay. And again, with the brush tool and the foreground color set to white, I'm going to paint in some more brightness in here. All right, much better. Then again, I'm merging those two. And now let's check the Nick Collection plugin. So first off, let's see what the polarization effect can do here. And I don't think I want to use this in this case. Then let's check the skylight filter. And this might actually look good, so let's just boost the strength a tiny bit. Okay, then let's add another filter. Brilliance warmth. Maybe a little warmth. Yeah, that's better. And let's add another filter. And I think the classical soft focus looks really, really good here. So let's go with the second one. And I only really want it over the center, so I'm just adding a positive control point just right here. Okay, then let's apply it like that. Very, very nice. So I think at this point I'm done with editing, so I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you for watching this video.